Last but not least is the exhaust port. Its main function is to eliminate the exhaust gases from the combustion chamber and to be high enough above the line of the transfers that most of that pressure is relieved by the time the transfers open at top RPM. But in the process, when designing or modifying an engine, we need to be somewhat aware of the effects of the top edge of the port. This edge out here. This is what Gordon Jennings had to say on the subject. He said that you improve ring life by rounding the shape of the port window and not letting it have sharp edges. Also, the ring may actually bulge out into the port window enough to cause its instant destruction in a square port. But the contours of an elliptical port window will sweep the ring gently back into its groove. That's all nice and good, and we all pretty much understand that, but we don't have any guidelines as far as to how strong or how weak a curve that needs to exist there at the top of the port. So on my motorized bicycle, these things are such wonderful, wonderful ways of doing experiments on two strokes to find out what the deal is. These cylinders are not made very strong. They're aluminum with a chromed inside lining. And what I did is I tried two different versions of the exhaust port. One with a gentle curve and one with a somewhat flat curve. This is a post on my two-stroke forum showing the two different shapes of exhaust ports. What I've done is quantify the curve by finding out the width of the curve section, that section that maintains that same curvature, and the height of it in the middle. Okay, so this is the rather flat curve, and this is the more generous curve. This one survived without any marks of the ring on the edge here. This is a picture of it after with a low flat curve, and what you see here is not very good. I don't have that good a camera. This shiny edge right here is from the ring hitting it and beating a bevel into it right there. So this probably wouldn't happen on a regular well-made cylinder, but these cheap junk Chinese cylinders can get damaged and abused pretty easily. So this is a worst case scenario. Okay, I understand that. There's probably rings and cylinders out there that might even be able to get away with it completely straight across top port. So, you know, but how much are we talking about here? That's not a huge curve. That still allows you to keep fairly well proportioned, almost flat at top. Let me also say that this port is 81% of the bore on paper. And I'm not really, I don't really think it's necessary to keep the port width to 75% of the bore on paper trace. I think the two main things that are important are that you don't get too close to the transfers and that you maintain a minimal curvature on the top, according to what my calculator says, which is takes into consideration the curvature and the RPM, or the speed, actually the speed of the piston as it crosses that port top, depending upon the port duration. So you've probably heard it said that the ring wants to spring out into the port. That's not true. The ring ends will spring into a transfer or intake port, but not at the exhaust port. That's not a springiness action. You can put a piston with rings in a cylinder in your hand and go up and down, and you not feel that ring hitting the port at all. What happens is that the ring is bulging, wanting to bulge outward because of the heat. As those exhaust gases leave, when the port is open, they are somewhat in touch with the ring right here, if you look at my drawing. So and it's the outer part of the ring. So it's basically if you had a straight ring metal and you put a blowtorch to it so that one side got hotter than the other, you would see it bend because of the expansion of the molecules, where it's hotter on this side than it is on this side. And that's basically what's happening here. So these are the factors involved: too much squish volume, allowing a longer burn with more heat at port opening, how long the rings are in touch with the cooler lower cylinder, because that gives them more time to cool down. The ring material, which has to do with the thermal expansion rate, which means has to do with how much they would want to curve with unequal heating. The maximum port width and the max RPM. The max RPM, because that's the amount of time you have for traversing the upper part of the port. So, there's a lot of different port shapes out there. This would be preferred, where all of it has a curvature. This one has a small straight section. This one has a small straight section. If we analyze ports as far as the width, the open width that the ring encounters as the piston is rising, the change in that width on this port right here is graphed in this blue graph right here. You can see it gets to be pretty sudden right there at the end, which is not ideal. A better version of that would be this one that has straight edges right here instead of curved, and that gives you this graph right here that shows same amount of change for the last three sections, which would be the last three of these little sections right here. So there's this one little sentence right here that's interesting. Seldom will there be any problem around the lower edge of the port as the piston slows considerably near the bottom of its stroke. So basically what he's saying that rate of change is the consequence of two things. This rate of change by the design of the port and the amount of time that it traverses that area with the piston speed. So this is my page about my free Excel spreadsheet that has a whole bunch of little calculators in it. And this is the website from which you can download it. This is the spreadsheet itself, and I'm going to scroll down. And get to this section right here, which is my port top calculator. So it's asking for when you, like, if you're designing a port, you have design in mind. What is that? What is the maximum width of that the top section with a pure curve? And what is the height in the middle? Should be these two numbers out here. The max RPM, the piston stroke, and the exhaust duration. The exhaust duration, because at different durations, the piston speed will be different. So after entering those five values, the program will give you a rating. And it says in the notes, the more this is above 1.0, the longer the rings will last. If it's below 1.0, then you need to raise the middle of the port roof, which is this section on here. So one being the cutoff zone, in this example right here, it's 12% in the sweet zone. So if you do porting, this is handy to have. If you have any question, you want to be safe, this is my advice. So it's a pretty good little spreadsheet. So I guess that's all I have on the subject for now. Thanks for watching.